In this video, I'm going to show you how to transfer your domain name from one place to another place. It's a very easy process, and I'm going to show you in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos that people can understand. I make them for non-techies, and if you like the content in this video, I release them every single day, pretty much. I'd like to encourage you to consider clicking on the subscribe button and maybe clicking on the little bell off to the side if you want video notifications from YouTube. So now that I got that out of the way, let's go through the process of transferring a domain name. Actually, someone just asked me for help with this. I thought it'd be a great topic for a video. Let me show you where I have all my domain names registered, and that's with a company called Namecheap. Now, most people just use GoDaddy. It's the first one they think of. I'll just go to GoDaddy. However, I find that Namecheap is just much better. It's a little less expensive, but that's not why I use them. I like their interface better, and I just really don't like much that has to do with GoDaddy on a personal level, but they're definitely changing. I think Namecheap is probably like the number two company to register and store your domain names at, and it's the one that I've always used. When you first register a domain name, they also give you domain privacy for free, but you do have to pay to renew that if you wanted to. So because there are so many different places that you can have your domain name registered, this video, I'm going to be mostly talking about how to do it in the concept, not actually showing you, because I can't show you for the 50 different companies that you could have your domain name registered at. And I'm going to show you how to transfer it to Namecheap, but the process is going to be pretty much the same for any place you want to transfer your domain name to. I like to keep my domain names at Namecheap versus with a web host, and that's just for being able to move around really easily. So I'm going to show you how to do it right now. Okay, so I'm on Namecheap's website, and any place you want to transfer a domain name to, they're going to have a register your domain name option and a transfer your domain name option. So I'm going to go ahead and click on domains and then transfer right here. And so all you need to do in this scenario is go ahead and put in the domain name that you want to transfer. So I'm going to enter a domain name right now. It's not my domain name, it's someone who's I know their domain name. So I'm just going to go ahead and enter that now and show you what it says. Okay, it's digitalage.com. I know the guy that has this domain name, and I know he's going to have something on it that I want to demonstrate. So there are a couple requirements before you can transfer a domain name. Let me first refer over here to the document for Namecheap. Now, I want to show you that I'm going to explain it all right now, but if you wanted specific instructions for your specific situation, I'm sure a quick Google search would definitely show that for you. So here's the document. It's very wordy, but I'm going to explain it. So before you, there's a couple steps before you can transfer, right? So the first thing you need to do is right here. Here's a requirement. The domain name you want to transfer cannot have been registered under 60 days ago or transferred someplace else under 60 days ago. So as long as you registered your domain name over 60 days ago or you transferred it somewhere over 60 days ago and then you want to transfer it someplace else, you are in the clear. The second one right here is the domain name must not be locked. So when you register a domain name, like for instance with GoDaddy, they give you the option to lock it, and that prevents any kind of changes happening on the domain name. So you're going to have to go in and unlock it. Next, let's take a look at the third thing right here. It says your domain must show a valid email address. So when you register a domain name, there's three contacts that are associated with it. And one of them is the admin contact, and that's a name, an email address, and an address. And there's an email address there. And so you need to be able to receive emails at that email address, because what happens in this process, an email to verify things is going to go to that email address. And so what this means is if you have privacy enabled on your domain name, you're going to temporarily have to disable that that privacy feature that you might have purchased. You're going to have to disable that, and you're going to want to make sure that that email address isn't some dummy email address you might have put in. It's a real email address that's going to go to you. So this is what happens. Okay, so here I am. I'm on Namecheap. I put the domain name in and it's given me some information. So right now under, it tells you where the domain name's registered. It's at GoDaddy. It tells you if it's locked, and right here it says it's unlocked. So great, 2 for 2. We're doing pretty good. Admin email, and it says unknown. This is because this domain name has the privacy turned on. If it didn't have the privacy turned on, it will show you the email address on that record. So because there is privacy on that domain name, it says unknown. So you can come here, and if you put your domain name in, you'll see, oh gosh, I got to resolve this email address issue. Let me go ahead and put a different domain name in. I'm going to put one in that is mine. Here it is, it's show the demo. I'm going to click on transfer and let's see what it shows me. Okay, here we go. It's saying it is unlocked, and right here it's showing an admin email, and this email address does go to me. So this is an example of a domain name that is all pretty much ready to go. It's meeting these three requirements. It's older than 60 days. Doesn't have privacy turned on. It's unlocked. I know I'm good to go. Now let's go back to those instructions. So this is really that first step of what you need. It's pretty simple, basic stuff there. Okay, so now what you need to do is where your domain name currently is, you need to get something called an EPP code, or it might be referred to as an authorization code. So they're going to give you this code and you're going to need to put that in. For example, where is it? Right here. You're going to need to put that code in right here. So then what happens is when you get that authorization code, you paste it in here, you can check out, pay for the domain name, and then an email is going to be sent right here. And what it's going to do is that it's just verifying the email and the ownership and all of that. There'll be a link. You click on it. Transfer is initiated and your domain name will be transferred within maybe 30 minutes or maybe up to 5 days, depending on where it's coming from. So if it's coming from like a GoDaddy or a big company like that, it'll be very, very quick. The transfer will happen. So now the next question is probably, well, how do I get that EPP code? Or how do I do some of these specific things? So on this document, and as a matter of fact, I'll put a link to this in the video description. When you scroll down, it has these associated articles. And so remember I just said a moment ago, just Google for specific instructions based upon where your name is registered and where you want to transfer it to. Well, right here, these results will end up coming up if any of those says Namecheap. So for example, here is specific instructions for GoDaddy, specific instructions for name.com. So let's go ahead and click on GoDaddy. Now when you scroll down, it gives you perfect images on how to unlock your domain name right here. And then right here, it tells you how to get your authorization code right here. And it's just walking you through. And then there's your authorization code. Looks like GoDaddy emails it to you. You click send. And you'll get it that way. And this is telling you how to turn off that privacy. So for example, if you're transferring from GoDaddy to Namecheap, you've got it all here. Very simple to follow with some images. So it's just a really simple process. Number one, you need to make sure that the domain name privacy is off. Number two, the administrative contact email actually goes to you and you get your authorization code. With that, you can go and transfer your domain name pretty much anywhere. So obviously the big variable is, how do you turn off the domain name privacy? How do you get that authorization code and stuff like that? And so where you have your domain name registered, they have support documents and they have support staff. You can just send them a message. Hey, how do I get an authorization code for this domain name? So it's very easy to get the little bits of help that you might need. Now, I have transferred domain names from very random places, and sometimes you have to get those codes from the support. I've experienced that before, and they took a long time to actually provide that back. And that's why I like to keep my domain names just at Namecheap. And once your domain name's at Namecheap, you can point it to anywhere you want, any web host you want. So if you had it on on one host and then you want to switch to a different host, you can easily change it because your domain name's there and you can just change the DNS settings. That should be for a totally different video. Now, the next question you might be thinking is, will there be any downtime when I transfer my domain name? The answer is 99% likeliness that there won't be any downtime, but you might have these little offshoot fringe little tiny companies and they kind of get all screwy and stuff like that. So there is the slightest possibility, but 99% chance that you won't have any downtime. So I wouldn't really worry about that. So anyways, this video was just about how easy it is to transfer your domain names. I also recommend and personally use Namecheap. I'll have a link to this article. I'll have a link to Namecheap down below. And if you are looking for a different web host, I'll also provide some links down below to some recommended web hosts that I have. So that's it for this video. If you had any questions that I didn't cover, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section down below. I'll definitely love to answer it for you and help you out in any way that I can. Hey, why don't you share it with me down below as well? What is your favorite place and to have your domain names registered at and why? Well, anyways, thank you for watching this video.